Hey everyone, Tony Vlahos here, Chief Marketing Officer of Executant, and I'm speaking today with Trish Goman. Hi, Trish.
Hi.
And Trish, of course, is an accomplished strategist and professor. She's also the co-author of What I Didn't Learn in Business School, How Strategy Works in the Real World. So just a few questions this morning. First, Trish, from any time in your life, what tough choices have you made that now guide or influence how you make new tough decisions?
That's a great question, and thanks for asking. I think earlier in my life, I tended to rely quite a bit on data. I was trained in mathematics and economics, and as I delve into data, it often seems to give you a great answer. What I've learned over time is the analysis doesn't really give you the answer, the strategy. It gives you a set of feasible options, and then you need to bring in the softer skills, the people, the political environment, and other changes that are going on to choose from among where your data takes you. I used to be just too reliant on the numbers.
It crowded out the faith.
Faith, that's a great faith. Faith in people and faith in your team.
Definitely.
I say I have a lot more faith than others now in terms of their instincts and experience and where that might take you in strategic decision making as opposed to just something that you might be able to do with a computer program.
Fantastic. So, Trish, what are one or two or three of the toughest challenges that organizational leaders need to overcome to lead us into the future?
Well, the first, I think, is to become comfortable with ambiguity and change. We do tend to, people don't achieve leadership positions without having strong points of view and being able to make commitments, stick to them, and follow through to the end. Increasingly, I find that the end is only the beginning of the next phase or the next stage. So being able to alter your perspective without looking like you're changing your mind, not to be flip-flopping, but to be a little bit open to new ideas, is a really fine line that I'm seeing some of the best leaders demonstrate how to do that delicate balance.
Wonderful. So are there one or two biggest lessons learned that might help others lead us who are facing similar challenges?
Indeed. I think we can all learn from watching others. Mm-hmm. I tend to look at press announcements where the instinct is to say, here's something sensational. Try to strip away the sensational piece and try to figure out what's the core issue, what's really at stake, what's this decision about? Not just the headline, and it might be a CEO leaving or a merger, an acquisition, but what's really going on under it? Mm-hmm. And try to tease that out, and you can learn so many lessons, or you can just ask better questions.
Wonderful. So last question, Trish. For all of those who are listening and watching our video, CEOs and their teams, is there one thing that you most want everyone out there to know about the future of their work?
Indeed. I think change can energize your team and can energize your whole organization, or change can destroy you. And to me, that's increasingly not something that happens to you, but a choice that you make through your culture, through the kind of incentives and objectives that you set and agree with your team and your people, and through your posture and the way you face the outside world. So this idea that change is a new constant is really old and kind of, we've all heard it before, but finding new ways to have change energize and inspire you would be what I'd hope that people are doing in their organizations today and going forward.
Wonderful insight. Thank you so much.
Thanks for having me.